Okay, I'm Pat with Greenwell Manufacturing with Pat's Easy Chains. How to replace your broken spring. They come from the factory with a rivet that attaches the spring to the casting. On the other end, attached to the latch, is with a hog ring. And I'll explain this to you as I go along. In order to get started, you will have to drill, grind, or file this off in order to get this rivet out. Then the latch is held in by a 3/8 row pin. So I'm going to drive this roll pin out. I've then lost my roll pin driver. Okay, to drive this roll pin out to place your latch, it's in pretty snug, so you need a 3/8 drift pin or a punch to where we can drive that out. Okay, I drove it through enough to where we can pull the latch out. This has our spring on it. Of course, I'll show you how to attach the new spring. Okay, with the latch out, we use the spring in the hog ring. It's usually turned 180 degrees out here. So if it was sitting hooked to the latch, where you got the flat part of the spring, we're just set down on the latch. So we'll hook the hog ring in, start it on one side, hook it on the back side. You can use a pair of channel locks to close that up. Now that has your spring attached back to your latch. Okay, then we can slide this back in our casting. I use the roll pin to line it up. And on the other side, we'll drive the pin back in. Okay, so now to attach the spring back to the castings. Of course, you'll have your latch stop. We're going to use a stainless steel Carter key. I'm going to open it up a little. So we can get it over our spring. Okay, it comes with a little washer that we can slip over our Carter key. Then you have your latch stop. We'll run it through the hole. Then we can push it over down back into casting. Then, on the inside of the casting, we'll grab it and you clench your Carter key over. Thank you. and just smash the Carter key down, and you're good to go. Back in business. And hope that helps you. If you have any problem, give us a call. Happy tractoring.